I remember the arches. I can see a deep valley. 17 arches cross it from one mountainside to the other. The side to the east is dead and dry, cold, quiet, and almost still. But on the other side are people, and it is living. There is movement and laughter, warmth. The arches widen to the west and carry them over them water from the black rocks. This water contains the future. In the center of the valley, I can see a dark river flowing through the seventh arch. The river seems deep and rushes towards me from the south. It carries the past, which lies to the other side of the construction. I stand in front of the river, in the present. Some arches are closed with brick. Some have green plants over them. Others are open and contain dreams. I remember these arches. The first arch is the widest. It is the arch of countryside. Through the second arch I can hear crowds. The third arch is of the evening. It lies to the west of the three arches of contrast, dying, and wings. The seventh arch spans the river. It is the arch of colors. The eighth arch holds secrets. The ninth arch is smooth and made of glass. I can see buildings on the tenth arch and windows. The high, narrow 11th arch contains weather. The 12th is of eyes. Then knives, animals, ropes, and order. The last arch, the narrowest and lowest, is the arch of fears. It touches the dead. It is the 17th arch. I remember these arches.
Thank you.
The arch of countryside, meaning to see. The first arch touches the living. It is one.
Clearings. This is the art for love. It's the most.
second arch shows people. It is the arch of crowds, meaning to hear. Hope.
The light is red with the glow of flames. In the center of the Arctic marsh shoots, strange animals stand fearless, shining green in the red light. At the rounded top of the arch are flames. Clouds hang over the river. It rains on the flames and the animals. This is the Arch of Elements. The fifth arch is the arch of dying. It is narrower still. The noise becomes fainter. I can hardly see the arch as the sun shines black against the new bricks. Of wings, it smoulders. The arch is narrow and high, it almost touches the river. The sixth arch reaches the damp ground. I can see the arch and the footprints of animals. I can hear breathing and the flapping of wings. Thank you. quarter! The sixth arch is the arch for birds. Minute or notice, it pours. The seventh arch is the arch of colours. This is the arch of the river. It is the highest and almost the narrowest. Through the arch, others the river. This is the arch for heads. The high, narrowest arch.
Into
side and shade. Some lie bleeding, others twist dead on the frozen sand bank. The bloodlight shimmers in the dry heat. The 10th arch is of building. of weather.
Machinery! Thank you.
fingers through the water.
Through the green leaves whispers the queen.
I can see eyes in the jeweled water.
Through the clouds whispers the queen.
No longer stands the king the highest over 50 men.
16 order stops rebels. 6 prince by the river. The debt measures. I remember the sun and their
sword, but
I can see you. Whispers the silence.
I dip the cut grass into cool autumn streams. I have carved out the gold rocks into frozen moss. And on the hillside I blunted my flat knife on the shadow of her sad memory. Did I build this stone shelter over the dark? Above my head is stone, under my feet is a rock. I look into the pale eyes crisping from the winter ice. I search for the smile caught on the dead face. And on the hillside, pilgrims see the untidy fields with the summer grass. I defile the furrows with the light green shoots. The stagnant animals defecate and sweat. The whole ground is green with the grass and the steam. Carefully, I shrink into the tiny furrows where the grey worms tangle and stretch into my nightmares. And on the hillside, my sword stabs into the snarled decay, killing the cries of the old fierce women.
17. Fear. Caught. Time. Lost. The crystal. The water. The tremble, the death, the dawn.
Thank you. Thank you.